And back home, the Premier says the bombings are a wake-up call for next year's G20 summit. It's also been a frantic and anxious day for the families of Brisbane runners caught up in the chaos. Max Futcher has more.
One of the world's most famous marathons draws athletes and fans from across the world. This morning, Brisbane residents were among those who found themselves in a nightmare.
The ground shook. The first one was about 10 seconds or so, or not even that, before the second one. We just saw people starting to run.
It's just this crazy, surreal time even now, I can see police walking outside the window here, checking cars.
Australian marathon runner Pat Carroll had friends in the race. They're safe, but he says he can't bring himself to watch the footage.
This may change the way that operations are at events now with regards to the start and the finish, and if it is, well, so be it.
The Gold Coast Marathon is a qualifying race for Boston. Its organisers were shocked by the overnight attacks, but say a strong security plan is already in place for the July event.
From a marathon point of view, the marathon community is talking. We're looking at what we can do together to make sure that the events continue and to share knowledge if there's any learnings from this.
But with more than 30,000 entrants along a 42-kilometre course, guaranteeing security is nearly impossible. The Premier says it sharpens focus on the Commonwealth Games and next year's G20.
I think there's been some very comprehensive planning going on at the moment for G20. This will just, I think, heighten the need for vigilance.
A massive undertaking to protect Brisbane from a Boston-style attack. Max Futcher, 10 News.